Ah, beautiful Yorkshire, home to the country's most breathtaking sceneries and wildlife. But the most interesting creature of all is without any doubt the YSTV member. Usually hiding in the studio, the species journeys out into the wild once a year for their annual bath in the sea. Let us follow them along on their trip. Journey begins early in the morning, and despite live streaming until late last night, the adventurers are overly excited and well fed. They are led by alpha male Edwin Barnes.
Hello.
We're in Whitby.
We're in Whitby.
We're going to Whitby.
In their van, YSTV make their way through the Yorkshire Dales, where just 2 hours later, they arrive at the sea.
I don't know, I just felt like being a bit different, you know?
Oh, wow.
Oh. Hey! Oh.
Having parked their van just outside the city and already hungry again, the group walks alongside Whitby's stunning cliffs and makes its way into the bustling town centre. Their minds set on one thing only.
We have a mission. Our mission is food.
Now I'm falling.
While most decide to try out Whitby's legendary fish and chips, Charlotte is looking for something sweeter.
Can't smell it.
While she gleefully enjoys her lollipop, the others take their meals to the beach for an authentic seaside picnic.
How did you not fall?
No.
Yeah, zoom in place.
Oh good, let's go get some scoop ice cream.
After having their hunger satisfied, a discussion arises within the group.
I didn't even know what we're discussing.
Well, are we not going to get ice cream?
Ice cream.
Ice cream.
With ice cream, YSTV ultimately arrive at the beach, very much to Zoe's happiness.
Oh. Donkeys, I'm gonna steal one. It's good, because animals shouldn't be contained, probably. That's bad. I see you.
Kids, eh?
Here we observe YSTV's habit of marking its territory with a logo. Just Joe seems to envision a cruder drawing.
It does look a bit weird, doesn't it?
Hey, I wasn't the one that decided to draw the penis, but you might as well make it a good penis.
That's quite a good length.
So you might as well add the droplets to the penis.
Here? Oh no! Oh! Put tire tracks on my penis. Let's walk away from the penis.
First time I've ever seen Tom do that.
Being kicked out of Whitby's beach, the group, now led by alpha female Olivia, plans to head south. Unfortunately, the trip's start brings unexpected problems.
That's Liam.
Oh, hey.
There we go.
Yeah, the boot is open.
I found it.
With all their personal belongings recovered, Olivia drives them down Yorkshire's coast, where they make a stop at the beautiful cliffs of Robin Hood's Bay.
Quite nice.
Robin Hood's Bay is a small and cosy fisher town. YSTV is mesmerised, while Carolyn wants to go shopping.
What's that?
They have some Crocs for £25, and I'm sure they'll fit a shoe, but...
It's got cars on them.
Oh, I like cars. No,
they're motorbikes.
It's a motor... Okay, so, Olivia, you do have your licence, right?
Yeah.
What's the difference between a car and a motorbike?
I mean, it's quite hard to tell.
It's a motorbike, it has two wheels.
Well, some cars have two wheels.
What cars have two wheels?
But not just Carolyn discovers something. Further down, Charlotte finds her namesake.
It's a boat dedicated to me, obviously, Charlotte, the only one in the whole entire world. Just gonna take this bad boy out to sea, do the old sailing thing. Yeah.
Unfortunately, YSTV is not allowed to steal the boat. Instead, the group meets up at the beach, where Edwin has good news. He discovered an old sewer. Due to its darkness and smell, it greatly resembles the YSTV studio, the group's natural habitat.
I like it here. With me.
So while most members take a peaceful nap, Joe and Zoe enjoy the romantic view over the beach. We better leave them alone. A few hours later, the group returns into the van in order to leave the bay behind. Despite the nap, some members feel a bit sleepy still and return to slumber in the back of the van. Olivia drives them even further south, towards the destination they've been looking forward to.
We're shopping!
Super noodles!
Got quite a bit of Pampers. I don't exactly want to go into why we have that, but I need it.
After their quick shopping spree, YSTV head deep into the forests outside Scarborough. Somewhere here, they hope to find an adequate camping place.
Hi, this is it. We've got camping booked. That way?
Yeah.
Lovely. Well, tell you what, we can make as much fucking noise as we want.
Yeah. Amazing.
Good news for the group. The big and empty field is perfect for the camp overnight. Tired but relieved, they vacate the van. An alpha male Edwin scouts the area, assisted by second-in-command Tom McGonagall. Together, they plan the camp's layout.
But that's just because I act like an idiot.
Yeah, same.
There we go.
We've arrived. We've decided where we are staying.
Only
and it's nice. It's nice weather. We're just about to pitch the tent.
Unfortunately, though, YSTV forgot that they suck at camping.
I'm not strong enough for this.
I'm trying to put a tent peg in.
What's a shoe? For 8 people, isn't that like a bit? Little space for 6 people.
What do you mean?
No,
this have is... you never had a tent orgy before, Tom? This is the perfect size.
He said, do you wash a potato? Do you not? Scientists are yet to decide, but what we're going to do is just cut them into some shapes using this knife, this butter knife.
Joe,
yes.
Is it broken?
Could be. If it wasn't, it is now.
What are you doing? How are you still working on this tent?
I'm just working slowly.
Thomas literally built his tent inside out. The inner bit's fine.
Fuck's sake.
God's sake. I'm meant to be good at camping.
With all their tents finally completed, new dangers for YSTV arise. At the early evening, the group realises in shock that both Charlotte and Olivia have gone missing.
They went over a fence and they saw some donkeys, so I don't know if they turned into the donkeys
Wait, where are white people? Should we go like on a rescue mission?
Find Olivia and Charlotte, who were kidnapped by geese and donkeys. Yes. But I'm a little bit scared, so we've got a knife and a stick to protect ourselves. Okay, should we rescue them?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Oh, hey. Found them. I mean, it's good, we're just preparing to... Well, it was supposed to be a rescue mission. Well, it was supposed to be a rescue mission.
For us?
Yeah.
Ah, you thought we needed rescuing.
Yeah, that's we thought nice. You were all dead.
Oh, I'm glad you care that we're dead. We weren't dead, but if we were, that would be nice. It wouldn't be much use because we'd be dead, but I appreciate the sentiment.
And so, the sun sets over YSTV's cosy camp. The whole group assembles around a small campfire, lit in a cheap barbecue tray by Tom. They are tired and cold, but can look back at a successful day. Soon after, they go to bed, for tomorrow shall be another exciting day.
Had a great night. Squished like sardines in a can. I don't like sardines.
It was fun. It was cozy. It was a bit cold. I've never slept in a tent before, but I enjoyed it. I was worried it would feel like I was going to sleep in a coffin, but it wasn't that bad. And now here we are.
It takes a while for the entire camp to wake, but teamwork shines through as they rip apart their nests. Well, in other words, they prepare to leave. They bid farewell to the other animals that they have encountered in their camp, and even though the goodbye is sad, the mood picks up as they load the van and ultimately set off, heading for their final destination.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
Jesus Christ, how do I keep forgetting this?
Do you want me to come with you?
Yes!
While Edwin and Charlotte head back to once again pay the parking fee they forgot, the group's youngsters are left to their own.
Hi, and welcome to Vlogging with Zoe Dickinson. Today, we've gone to Scarborough to look at things in Scarborough. There's a beach, look!
Rejoining the group, Charlotte is plagued by severe hunger.
Yeah, I'm just hungry.
But Carolyn has a cure.
The number of cups of tea that I had just there in Wetherspoons, like, has, I think, made me hotter, and now I'm sweating and it's really, really unpleasant.
To escape the 21st century problem of sweat, the group journeys on until they find this scene in Scarborough's beautiful sunny summer beach, the crown jewel of Yorkshire.
Are you cold? It's cold a bit, isn't it?
Yeah.
Still, the cold and the wind don't distract YSTV from the pure joy of having found the sea. Finally, their endurance is paying off. Together, they erect their new homes in the sand of Scarborough Beach. And then, the time for their annual bath has come.
Do something exciting.
Okay, ooh, let's do it. Okay, come on.
How was it?
I'm not gonna lie, it actively fucking hurts. Like my feet are really cold and on fire at the same time. And I feel really bad for like leaving Olivia all on her own out there.
Her balls are like five sizes the size of mine.
Damn.
It's water.
It's really fucking cold water.
With every joyous splish and splash, Olivia leads the way into the crashing North Sea waves. Finally, it is Tom McGonagall. He finds his courage and joins her paddling. It is here we must leave them. Until next time, in beautiful Yorkshire.